This week on Maker Update, a plant that gives you your life back, a sound sculpture that's the bee's knees, breathing life into animatronics, and turning purge poops into jewelry. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we find all the coolest projects that makers are making and share them with you to hopefully inspire you in your own projects. I'm Tyler Weingartner and I hope you're all doing great. We've got a cool show for you, so let's get started with the project of the week. Many years ago, Simone created the applause machine, a machine that would automatically give you a standing ovation when triggered by a particular event. In Simone's case, she was trying to build some better habits, so every time she completed a small task or chore, applause. But now she has another habit she'd like to break, spending too much time on her phone. And to break this habit, she'll need a more potent motivator, which is why she's made this small plant enclosure that shields it from sunlight. At the top of the enclosure is a small LED grow light. But the grow light only turns on when Simone places her phone in this slot at the bottom of the enclosure, where it's out of her hands and off her mind. And if she doesn't do that, the plant won't get enough light and it'll die. After finding the ideal size and shape container for the enclosure, she created this dome piece of wood to match the interior, as well as the base, which held the slot for her phone, the enclosure for the electronics, and the base for the plant. It's all made from CNC cut hardwoods, and it looks quite handsome when assembled. For the electronics, she's using an Arduino Uno, a Hall effect sensor to detect Simone's phone, a relay to switch the grow light off and on, and a display to count up the amount of time her phone is spent in the enclosure, making sure the plant inside gets enough light to thrive. It will count up to a maximum of 4 hours of light for the plant every day, and the counter resets at midnight. There's a real-time clock managing all the timekeeping for this project. It's an interesting philosophy for a project, making yourself accountable to yourself by improving your habits, while also being accountable to another living thing. During the project, she also shared another great bit of shop philosophy. Don't rush if you don't have to. We all get excited by our projects and sometimes push ourselves to get a little bit more out of the day. But when you're rushing, that's when you're most likely to make mistakes that you can't fix. It's a great project overall and a fun video. Check it out. More projects. From Daric, Gill, we have this museum-grade sound sculpture that was created, in part, by bees. It uses a combination of a PIR sensor and an ultrasonic rangefinder to detect the presence of people. And the closer you are, the richer the sonic experience it presents. He began by making these wooden amplifier cones. He had to make these first because they'd spend the next few months in a beehive while the bees filled them with honeycomb, which will be used to filter the sound from the speakers. The rest of the enclosure comes together in a similar fashion, and the design continues with a hexagonal motif. This is a thorough video, but he goes into painstaking detail of how much consideration goes into the making of a museum-quality project. Jigs to ensure perfect cuts, the best clamps for strange joints, even making sure the wiring of your electronics is attractive for the odd person who peers into the control interface. It's a gorgeous project. Kiara's workshop has another fun animatronic project. And this time she's recreating everybody's favorite novelty singing fish, Billy Bass, as the Pokemon Magikarp. The trickiest part of this project for her is creating the skin that will make up the outer shape of the body. She's using this casting silicone called dragon skin and brushing it into these massive 3D printed molds. After learning that automotive filler primer arrests silicone curing, she used a special compound called Inhibit X to seal off the primer completely. For the internals, she has a 3 servo armature, one to move the tail, another to move the head, and a smaller one to open and close the mouth. To create all the animations and time them to music, she's using Bot Tango, which is a free and open source software designed to help you animate animatronic characters. Because of the mass of Magikarp, his dance moves are maybe a little less sprightly than his little brother Billy, but It's a fun way to recreate a classic project. Valentin Felder has a great video on how he created this breathing armature to help him animate one of the characters in his stop motion film. He begins by analyzing the breathing motion so he can understand what this armature needs to actually do, and then creates a few simple paper models. The actual armature uses a lead screw with two different thread pitches, one to push out the belly and another to expand the sides. It's a clever mechanism, and you really get to see the quality on the screen with this one. Speaking of clever mechanisms, we have another beautiful circuit sculpture by HuyVector. This one is a flower that blooms as the LEDs are illuminated. Each petal is sculpted individually before attaching them by way of a hinge to this hexagonal piece. Further into the flower, there's this other hexagonal piece that forms the linkage of the petal mechanism. Servos drive the mechanical actuation, and it's all triggered by a touch sensor in the base. I also love that there are no external wires coming out of the flower pot enclosure, thanks to the inductive charging pad in the base. Time for some tips and tools. If your maker journey has taken you anywhere near InfoSec, folks, you've likely heard about the Flipper Zero, an electronics multi-tool that can spoof RFID and NFC tags. Snorin is taking a look at a very similar piece of hardware called the Kiisu V4B. It runs the same firmware as the Flipper and provides a number of the same functions, but it has a more compact design and is half the price. It also adds a compass, accelerometer, temperature and humidity sensor, and a light sensor. There are some compromises around battery life, but there are terminals to solder in your own battery, complete with a charging circuit. Over on Instructables, Penelope Bulnick has a great tip for how to make multicolor earrings from scraps of melted filament. If you have a multicolor printer, you get these little purge poops every time you change color. And they're all in different colors, and they usually just go to waste. But with the help of a sacrificial toaster oven, she's melting down these poops into silicone molds to give them new life as multicolored jewelry pieces. And you don't even need a fancy 3D printer to use this technique. You can just snip off small pieces of filament to achieve the same effect. A deburring tool helps clean up any stray flashing. Also on Instructables, from PocketBoy, we have a guide on how to add electronic triggers to your acoustic drum kit. His goal with the project was to reduce the sound produced by his kit because he lives in an apartment, but would still let him practice. But there's so much that can be done with electronic triggers, such as adding additional sounds, lights, you name it. In each drum, he's building a bridge across the span of the drum shell using a paint stirrer and sandwiching a piezo sensor between the two pieces of foam. The wires from the piezo sensor are then wired into a TRS jack to connect them into an electronic drum module, but these could also easily connect into any microcontroller. And from here, the sky's the limit. And from Liz Clark and Adafruit, we have a great guide on how to create a DIY version of ambient video lighting. This is the effect where you add recessed RGB LEDs behind your television to make it seem like what's happening on screen is being extended onto the wall behind it. This is run in a piece of software called Hyper HDR running on a Raspberry Pi that captures the video signal going to the TV and adapts it to the RGB LED strips behind the display. Great stuff. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, Becky Stern has a great guide for the gift-giving season with this video about her favorite tools and finds from 2025. Whether it's a great set of automatic wire strippers, a handy portable toolkit, or the iFixit portable soldering station, there's tons of great ideas here either for yourself or for another maker in your life. And don't miss her segment on connectors as stocking stuffers. I'd be pretty excited to get some TRS connectors or heatset inserts myself. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. A reminder, as always, that you can get more info about every single one of these projects by checking out the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment, give us a thumbs up, and hit subscribe so you won't miss the next one. Huge thanks, as always, to DigiKey for making this show possible and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.